another edition of Final Fantasy 6 T Edition. This time we take our party here and take on Kefka, with Raya from Final Fantasy 4, Xdeath from Final Fantasy 5, Lulu from Final Fantasy 10, and Tonberry, aka Pug, from a bunch of Final Fantasy games, including this one. And to show you the rest of the costumes, it's Locky the Sky Pirate from something, probably from Final Fantasy IX, apologies if I'm mistaken, and then just from the last video, we have Waka, we have Cypher, and we have Fusogao. Here we have Shadow in his true form, we have Vayne from FF12, we have Cyan as Cid from Final Fantasy Tactics Advance, and we have Realm as Kryle, aka Kara, from Final Fantasy V. Not that most of these characters matter, because we are here to beat Kefka with this party, because they are MVPs. You should have seen this coming. And, by the way, you should have also seen coming the request for liking and subscription, because that makes me feel better, it makes you feel better. Hallelujah. Let's do this. Welcome, friends. I knew you'd come, so I've been practicing my greeting. Ha! How much do you have to destroy before you've had your fill, Kefka? Acquired the ultimate power. Behold! Such magnificent power. You're nothing more than fleas compared to me now. Embrace your destruction. It is the inevitable. It is the fate of all things. To be destroyed, maybe tis, but people can always rebuild, and new lives will always be born. And time? Oh, time will destroy all those as well. Why do people insist on creating things that will inevitably be destroyed? Why do people cling to life, knowing that they will someday, no, they must someday die. Knowing that none of it will have meant anything once they do. Because it's not the end that matters. It's knowing that you have something to live for right now, at this moment. Something you've worked for. Something that's worth protecting. As long as you have that, it's enough. And did you all find your somethings in this broken world that just won't die? Yes. Love. Person worth protecting. Ah, my woman and my child live on within me. Friends and family. A peaceful kingdom. A loving brother who always looks out for me. Someone who's willing to accept me for who I am. An adorable little granddaughter. An obnoxious grandpa who I couldn't live life without. Wings from a dear old friend. Oh. Malulu, I believe in my friends.
Come on.
Saving the world by copying people. Ah, you people make me sick. You sound like chapters from a self-help book. If that's how it'll be, I'll snuff all of them out. Every last one of your sickening, happy little reasons for living. No, Kafka, stop! My Eye of Judgment. I wield the greatest power in existence. And you are but nothing to me. Behold, I am an angry god, and all of you are sinners in my presence. You may as well be the dirt on the bottom of my boots, the shit on my ass. I will destroy everything. I'll create my own empire of death. You can't destroy everything. People will always have dreams. No, I'll destroy the entire world. There won't be anything left to dream about. We won't let you hurt any more people. But what fun is destruction if no precious lives are lost? It ends here, Kafka. It's finally time to die. Terra? Gogo? Seals? Mog? Strago? The Figaros? And whatever. Actually, no, not whatever. Realm? Sure. Don't care about the elixirs. They took off our floating effect. Such a relief not to be having to face 10 enemies in a row that are all boss quality. Thank you. Yeah, I'm going a bit easy on them just for the sake of getting these things killed. We don't need to go full force, I'm pretty sure. But we'll still act wisely, because this has seemingly been upgraded since vanilla. It definitely feels upgraded. Yeah, these things have far, far more health than in vanilla, to my recollection. Hey look, it's Jesus! In the middle there! Wearing what looks to be, feminine undergarments. And of course, the guy in the front, too. You're the front man. If this were vanilla, the enemies would have almost certainly been killed by now. We are now on a death timer. Time to kill him even faster. And that is one way to bring your MVP team through Kafka's fight gauntlet into the final battle. Here we go. Life, dreams, hope. Ha! Where do they come from, and where do they go? Such meaningless things. I'll destroy them all. I'll create a monument to non-existence. Ha! Curious how he counters this. No counter from Kafka. Thousand damage from one Ultima. That is a record. Tales of Arise. Thank you.
Dragonflight!
Yeah, or not.
What? That is new and unpleasant. What happens if we dispel? I count that as a brief victory. I count that as total BS. Is that... I'm curious, is this what happens if you don't kill him fast enough? So let's go back in time and lay on some more smackdown. He's simply invincible for now. I He can be killed somehow. Wow. Is this a matter of going back in time and just rasping him to death? Let's check. Okay, so apparently we need to kill him faster? I'm not sure, I'm getting mixed signals here. Let's just go back to this point in time. I might know how to survive this, but it requires restarting the fight. Alternatively, updraft at the right time. Nope, it must be updraft. I'm so glad we have an emulator. Well, that's good to know. It works on him. Let's also check some stats here. Thank you. Let's try this. Oh, see, this is still stopped. Ow! Thank you. beat him a certain way? Whereas other victories that seem like they would work simply fail? Let's find out. Alright, if you're gonna play cheap, I will too. Who's your daddy? Thank you.
Then take that, you son of a bitch. Bye, Kubo!
Yes, and good riddance!
Kefka, I wanted you to know I've always hated you. Always.
And that is one way to beat Kefka in FF16 edition. Bring up draft. You will need it. This also marks the end of this episode. Thank you, everyone. Good night, and God bless.